الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله، أحثكم وإياها على طاعته، وأحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته ومعصيته، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا شيء مثله ولا شيء قبله، قديم بلا ابتداء، دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد، ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت، قيوم لا ينام. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا المصطفى، محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا ونور قلوبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، رضي الله عن صحابته وعن آله وعن قرابته وعن أحبابه وعن أزواجه ومن اتبعهم بإحسان وتمسك بالثقلين إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، يريدون ليطفئوا نور الله بأفواههم. This ayah actually came many times في القرآن العظيم. And this meaning of the specific ayah or the translation of this ayah, they want to extinguish the light. In a sense, not really, we should not say the nur, the light, I apologize about that. They want to extinguish the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their mouth. In that sense, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lights our pathway with the guidance. That's the meaning that we allude to, but I don't want to say light that people do not think it's an actual photons. No? Of course, that light may enlighten someone, and that's where enlightenment comes from. No. Which is arriving to the truth, or al-haqiqa, or al-haq. يُرِدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. They want to extinguish the nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent with their mouth, with their words, with their fights. وَيَأْبَى اللَّهُ إِلَّا أَن يُتِمَّ نُورَهُ. And Allah wills but to complete His nur, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is known that if you want to achieve something, you have to sacrifice for it. A student that wants to achieve a degree must study. Without studying, without sacrificing, without suffering, sometimes even further, more than sacrifice, there has to be some suffering sometimes, you will not attain what you want. Take the independence of countries, such as the independence of this country. When this country became independent from Britain, there was much sacrifice and lots of suffering and lots of battles and lots of things. Huh? Until nowadays you see on some bumper stickers, freedom is not cheap, or freedom is not free. Correct? Absolutely. In the sense, that is true. That's a true thing. Freedom is not free. Look at Algeria, for example. The independence of Algeria cost them 1.5 million shaheeds, martyrs, simply for to gain that freedom that they wanted. They had to sacrifice to attain it. Look at South Africa. Huh? Of course, the man who they considered the terrorist, and they considered him a threat against the world, and they consider him all these things, Mandela, right? All of a sudden, they put him in jail years and decades. All of a sudden, he became a national figure. Things changed. Why? Because the people believed in that concept. They believed in that principle, and freedom is not free. And depending on the goal that you want to achieve, then the sacrifice will also increase. If the goal is higher, the sacrifice must be higher. If the goal is more superior, then the sacrifice and the suffering must be even more superior in its level, quantity and quality. Huh? Notice now, going from the, look, India, the independence of India, thousands and thousands of people, though Gandhi, when he was doing this, let's say, if we were to say that, just now, we're not going into the details, but let's say, in that movement of, in India, which was supposed to be absolutely non-violent movement, correct? Gandhi said, no, you know, non-violence is a weapon that knows no defeat, we will not use any violence, yet still, thousands and thousands and thousands of people were murdered and slaughtered simply for their non-violence. Huh? Non-violent approach and demand of their own personal independence and freedom. What? Look at Al-Anbiya alayhi salam. Al-Anbiya as a better example here. Al-Anbiya alayhi salam, look at for example Nuh. Nuh alayhi salam, day and night is calling him, his people for what? To be independent. To free themselves from these ideas that tell them that you must worship an idol and anyone who doesn't worship an idol must be killed. Huh? Man, this is the point. Yani the people in Quraysh, what did they fight the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for and his ashab radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim ajma'in? They fought them, يَقُولُ رَبِّي Allah. Like Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu says, you are fighting someone just because he says رَبِّي Allah. Notice. But because the goal is very superior, and the goal is very important, and the goal is very detrimental, the sacrifice then must equal that. Look at Zakariya alayhi salam. Look at Musa alayhi salam. Huh? How many times Musa, when he goes to Fir'aun, he has to. Fir'aun, the man with all these with all these palaces and all these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders Musa by himself, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to Fir'aun. Yeah, go by yourself. Huh? And then he said, رَبِّي جَعْ وَزِيرًا مِنْ أَهْلِي, I just won't take Harun with me. Go take Harun and go. He, both of them, both, two people, they went to the palace of Fir'aun. Jesh, armies, huh? Yani at that time, if you want to call it, every kind of army, every kind of armed forces are sitting in front of Fir'aun's palace. That tyrant that said, "Ana rabbukum al-a'la wal-i'adabal." I said, "I am your supreme lord." That's it. But still, Musa and Harun are commanded to go and talk to this Pharaoh, to this tyrant, to this dictator, to tell him about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huh? And say simple things. If you want your kingdom to continue, just believe in Allah, la ilaha illallah. Believe in that Lord that created you. You are not a Lord. You are not a God. You are not a creator. There is someone who created you that you should believe in. Simple. Yeah. Go to Yahya alayhi salam. Yahya alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of course talks about him in the Quran. Huh? وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحُكْمَ صَبِيًّا. This Yahya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this, the ruling, gave him the leadership, gave him the knowledge, gave him all these things. What happened to Yahya alayhi salam? Yahya alayhi salam, النبي, Nabiullah Yahya. And he is the Prophet of Allah. Because he said the truth and he stood on the truth, they decapitated his head. Huh? They cut his head off and put it on a tray and gave it as a gift to one of the women from Bani Israel. This is a gift. What is the gift? رأس نبي, the head of Nabiullah Yahya alayhi salam. Why? Because there is a price to pay for saying the truth. The truth is usually not popular. And if you say it, there's a price to pay. But some people will not change. They will not change because of that price. Most people will. But some won't. And those that don't are the role models of humanity. Those are the free men.